After years of delays and technical challenges, the U.S. Army is gearing up to deploy its much-anticipated Dark Eagle long-range hypersonic weapon, LRHW, by the end of fiscal year 2025. This update follows a recent U.S. congressional report, confirmed by a defense official to Defense News, stating that the Army aims to field the first LRHW unit within the next year. The original plan was to equip the 1st Multi-Domain Task Force, 5th Battalion, 3rd Field Artillery Regiment, 17th Field Artillery Brigade at Joint Base Lewis-McChord, Washington, with the LRHW by fall 2023. However, persistent issues with the launcher and launch sequence forced the Army to push back its timeline. A government watchdog report previously pointed to these technical difficulties as a major factor behind the delays, noting that while the missile itself remained functional, complications with the firing mechanism and range conditions led to several aborted tests. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the Dark Eagle long-range hypersonic weapon will be a game-changer for the U.S. military. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Dark Eagle consists of a ballistic missile, an all-up round, or AUR. The missile is encased in a canister. The missile has a diameter of 34.5 inches. To give viewers a perspective, a Tomahawk cruise missile has a diameter of about 20 inches. The missile has a common hypersonic glide body, CHGB, placed on top of it, which will be used by the Army, Navy, and Air Force. Dynetics is responsible for the CHGB, while Lockheed Martin will build the booster as well as assemble the missile and launch equipment. The CHGB is reportedly based on the alternate reentry system developed by the Army and Sandia National Laboratories. It uses a booster rocket motor to accelerate to well above hypersonic speeds and then jettisons the expended rocket booster. The TELs, or Transporter Erector Launchers, are the modified M983 A4 Heavy Expanded Mobility Tactical Trucks. M983 A4 is currently being used in the Patriot Anti-Aircraft Missile System. An M870 trailer will be used to move the TEL. AFTDS, or Advanced Field Artillery Tactical Data System, version 7.0 will be present for battle management duties. Each TELS will have two missile canisters. The Dark Eagle is organized into batteries. According to the U.S. Army, a Dark Eagle battery consists of four TELS, one Battery Operations Center, BOC, for command and control, and a BOC support vehicle. The Dark Eagle is a critical element of the U.S. military's hypersonic weapon arsenal. An object is said to be hypersonic once it exceeds the speed of Mach 5, which is 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. The fierce speed of hypersonic weapons and the ability to fly in erratic paths give them a much higher probability of penetrating modern air defenses. They will be very hard to track, let alone intercept. It is to be noted that traditional ballistic missiles also reach hypersonic speed when they descend down on the target, but they follow a relatively predictable parabolic path, which leaves scope for interception by anti-ballistic missile defense systems. Hypersonic weapons are mainly of three types: hypersonic cruise missiles, HCM, that use scramjet engines, air-launched ballistic missile, ALBM, and hypersonic glide body, which is what Dark Eagle is. The CHGB in Dark Eagle is launched to extremely high altitudes using the ballistic missile, where it skips across the Earth's upper atmosphere. Then it separates from the carrier and glides back to the Earth towards its intended target, attaining hypersonic speed. The flight profile will make it very challenging for enemy air defenses to detect and neutralize the threat before impact. This is crucial since adversaries are deploying long-range air defense systems. For example, Russia has S-300, S-400, as well as S-500, whereas China has HQ-9 SAM. Near-peer rivals are basically trying to create an anti-access and area denial A2AD umbrella with an aim to protect the military infrastructure from U.S. strikes in case a conflict starts. With an operational range of 2,700 kilometers, or about 1,675 miles, and capable of speeds greater than Mach 5, Dark Eagle is designed to strike high-value targets with unparalleled precision and speed. In 2018, America's Government Accountability Office, GAO, report stated, China and Russia are pursuing hypersonic weapons because their speed, altitude, and maneuverability may defeat most missile defense systems, and they may be used to improve long-range conventional and nuclear strike capabilities. There are no existing countermeasures. As stated by U.S. DoD leaders, hypersonic weapons are a national imperative. In 2021, Michael E. White, Principal Director for Hypersonics, said the adversaries have increasingly focused on systems that dramatically compress the timelines and the timescale of a tactical battlefield. He indicated that an American portfolio of subsonic and supersonic weapons would be found wanting in a battle. He stated that the U.S. Department of Defense has developed the Hypersonics Modernization Strategy that accelerates the development and delivery of transformational warfighting capabilities based on hypersonic systems. In this context, viewers may note that Russia has already fielded Kinzhal, Avangard, and Zircon, and China has deployed DFZF. Given the scenario, Dark Eagle becomes crucial. Although the U.S. Army's plan to field the Dark Eagle has faced delays, it has been pointed out by officials that it has been in development for just over 5 years, while a missile development programs typically take about a decade. The nature of the weapon makes extensive testing essential, as the components like onboard electronic thermal shield must be validated to work in extreme temperatures, reaching up to 3,000 degrees Fahrenheit. The U.S. Army conducted an end-to-end successful flight test of this hypersonic weapon at the Pacific Missile Range facility in Hawaii in May 2024, and we can be more or less certain that it won't be too long before the weapon is fielded.